For coatings to perform as designed, a continuous film of proper thickness must be applied. Most coating specifications indicate the dry film thickness, or DFT, required for each layer to be applied, but the painter can't wait until the next day to determine whether the proper thickness has been achieved. Instead, measurements of the wet film thickness must be taken while the coating is being applied so that adjustments to the application process can be made. The wet film thickness may be shown on the product data sheet, but this isn't always the case because it can vary depending on how much thinner is applied to the coating and the actual dry film that is being required by the specification. Therefore, it's important that you know how to calculate the target wet film thickness for both thinned and unthinned coatings. In order to determine the target wet film thickness, you need three values. The first is the target dry film thickness, or the DFT, of the coating. Second, the solids by volume of the material being applied. And third, the amount of thinner that will be added to the coating. Now, where do those values come from? Well, the first, the target dry film thickness, you'll find from the specification. For example, it might say the prime coat should be applied to a dry film thickness of 2 to 4 mils. If the specification is silent, suggested thickness ranges can also be found in the product data sheet, but the specifier should be contacted in this case to confirm that that is the desired thickness for the project. The second value, the solids by volume, is taken right off the product data sheet. It's typically expressed as a percentage. This value represents the non-volatile or non-evaporating components of a coating, such as the resin, pigment, and additives. The third value, the amount of thinner that will be added to a coating, is usually expressed as a percentage. The amount is usually depending on the specific application conditions being encountered in order to achieve proper atomization and flow of the film. The total amount allowed is usually capped, though, based on the VOC regulations, with the maximum amount shown in the product data sheet. If it isn't shown, the manufacturer should be contacted for the limitations in the area or region of the country where the coating is being applied. The amount of thinner added to the coating will affect the thickness of the wet film being applied. It adds to the volume of the wet paint and is therefore part of the wet film measurement, but the thinner doesn't remain as part of the dry film, that is, it evaporates into the air. Now that we have all three values, our target dry film thickness, the percentage of solids by volume, and the percentage of thinner being added, we can calculate the target wet film thickness. There are two formulas to select from when determining the wet film to be applied. The first formula is used when no thinner is added. The second is used when thinner is added. For the first formula, you're looking at the dry film thickness divided by the solids by volume of the coating. That's equivalent to the wet film thickness. For the second formula, we have to determine the new solids content in the coating after we add thinner. So that's the first step. In order to do that, we take the solids by volume in the can from the PDS and divide that number by 100% plus the percent thinner that is added. That now gives me the new solids. The second step then is dividing the desired dry film thickness by that new volume solids after thinning. That gives me the wet film thickness. For example, assume we want to apply 7 mils of coating and there's 75% solids by volume in the can, no thinning. In this case, 7 mils divided by 75% solids is 9.3 mils wet. Let's assume now that we thin that paint by 15%. So we need to first figure out the new solids by volume. I do that by taking the solids in the can, 75%, and divide that by 100% plus 15%, or divided by 115%. That calculates to a new solids by volume after thinning of 65%. I take the same 7 mils, divide it by the new solids of 65%, and we're applying 10.8 mils wet film thickness. In other words, without thinner, to get 7 mils, we apply 9.3 mils. With thinning, we apply 10.8 mils. That's all there is to it. You can log on to ktauniversity.com for other instructional videos on coding application and many other subjects.